Okay, so what we're going to do here today is we're going to anodize. I'm going to show you a cheap and easy way to anodize and re-anodize titanium parts using stuff you see in front of you and some of this stuff. That's distilled water there. You want to make sure that you clean the piece off real well after you put your gloves on with either isopropyl alcohol or acetone, and then don't touch the piece after you clean it off. It's real important that you don't have your skin oils on the piece when you go to anodize it. Alright guys, first thing you need to do is you need to take a little bit of the baking soda and pour just a little bit of that in your cup there. You don't have to measure it. It doesn't have to be a certain amount. Just get some in the cup there. Then you're going to take your distilled water, okay? And you want to fill that cup up with distilled water. This is going to be your anodizing bath. All right. So then you can take the other end of your fork there, or whatever you're using. It has to be a piece of metal, preferably stainless steel. Getting that all mixed up there. Okay, now the baking soda is dissolved into the distilled water there. Okay, now we're gonna need something to anodize. So I have this knife here that I anodized previously, but if you can see, some of the anodizing is coming off at the top of the clip there and a little bit down to the bottom here. So I wanna re-anodize this, okay? So what I'm gonna do for you guys is I'm gonna take it all the way to bare titanium and then re-anodize it back to the color I want. Okay guys, I got my clip off here, and the first thing I want to do is I want to get a pair of gloves on, because once you get your part cleaned up, well, you don't want to get any of this stuff on you, but once you get your part cleaned up, you don't want to get any of your skin oils on the part, because it will screw up the anodizing process. So put on a pair of rubber gloves, and then we will take our titanium wire. I got this off of eBay. I got 5 feet of titanium wire for like $1.25. It's really not expensive at all, but definitely something you're going to need for this process. Another thing I got off of eBay is this. It's called Whink Rust and Stain Remover. And this is probably the number one key to this process here. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut a small piece of the titanium wire. Cut a piece of this. And that's going to be what we use to dip our clip in. Okay. So run that titanium wire through one of the screw holes. And you can go right ahead and twist that so that thing's not going anywhere. Okay, so there you go. Focus there. We got her there. All right. Now, what we've got here, we've got our anodizing tub. We've got a tub of regular distilled water. Then we've got Windex. Okay. I have them in these tubs because you can reuse all of this stuff. And then in this container here, I have the Whink Rust and Stain Remover. be very careful with that stuff, because that is some nasty stuff. That's why I have it in this extra tub to contain it if it spills. You don't want to get that stuff on you. You don't want to breathe in the fumes, and you don't want to spill it, okay? So that is the key to all of this, all right? As you can see right now, this clip is plenty blue, okay? So all you got to do, if you want to get rid of that anodizing, and this will remove any of your anodizing, you want to just pop this in the Whink Rust and Stain Remover for about 10 seconds, okay? Keep a close eye on it, because it acts fast. It will strip all of the anodization off of your part, okay? And now it's stripped. Shake it off. You want to go into the distilled water to rinse it. Give it a good rinse. Then into the Windex. Okay. And then rinse it one more time, and then leave it in your distilled water bath until you're ready to anodize. Okay, so we're all set up here to go now. I have three batteries, because three batteries is going to give me the blue color that I want. If I did two batteries, it would give me a much more purple color. And one battery gives me the bronze kind of straw color, but I want three for the blue I'm looking for. Remember, when doing this, you want to daisy chain your batteries together, then hook up black to negative, red to positive for your alligator clips. Then you hook up your negative directly to the metal that you have going into your anodizing bath, and then we can hook up our positive to our titanium wire. Now, the wire to the piece has to be titanium. It'll screw it up if it isn't titanium, so you got to get the titanium wire. But then immediately after we pull our piece out of the distilled water, we want to put it in the anodizing bath, and it'll happen quickly. So I'll put it in there. And you see it bubbling, changing color, purple. We want to shake it, give it a little bit of time in there, let our color soak to get that nice blue we're looking for. Oh yeah, this is coming out good. Okay. Now, as soon as we pull it out of the anodizing bath, you want to put it right into the distilled water to give it a good rinse. And there you are. That is the piece re-anodized. All the issues are gone, and it's a nice blue, exactly the color we were looking for. Okay, now, if you guys want to see the other colors, we can do that. You can actually leave it connected or disconnected. It really doesn't matter. But if you want to get rid of that blue to try a different color, you want to go back into the Whink. Want to watch it until all of your color is dissolved. Takes about 20 or 30 seconds to get all the way back to bare. When you see it start bubbling, you know that you're back to bare titanium. You can actually watch it eat away the anodizing. So now, as you can see, we're back to bare titanium. We'll keep it in the water there, and we'll take unhook this, pop one of these batteries out. I'll tell you what, we'll pop both of these batteries out. Oh. Reconnect. All right, now this is going to give us a bronze color into the solution here. You see, it's starting to get that nice bronze color. You want to make sure you don't touch the metal post here with the metal in here, otherwise it'll arc. All right, now we have our bronze. We dip it there. And you can see the bronze straw color. Now, from the bronze straw color, you can go up, but you can't go back down. So from this color, I can add a battery. Show you this. Pop this. Add a battery. Now, I can dip it. We're getting close there. See, it's going to purple. Pull it out. Rinse it. There's purple. Decent purple, but not really what I'm looking for on this clip. So we'll add back in that third battery. And then pop her in. You want to make sure if there's any air bubbles on the surface of your piece, you want to get them off because it won't properly anodize if there are air bubbles on it. So you want to kind of move it around a little bit. Give it time to fully take in all of that color. And there you have it. We're back to the blue we're looking for. So that's all there is to it. Another thing you want to remember when anodizing, if you're going to be dipping a whole piece, make sure you put a little bit of nail polish over anything you don't want anodized, like a detent ball, because you will really screw up your detent ball if you put that in there without painting over it. That's about all I got, guys. Just remember to like, subscribe, and share this video. Give me a comment. Let me know what you think.